Welcome to Module 3, Blockchain Ecosystem and Barriers. Now we have understood how blockchain applications work in tandem with internet protocols and what different kinds of blockchain applications are being developed today. In this module, we will first cover how the blockchain ecosystem is organized and then we'll focus on the barriers to the adoption of blockchain technology. Within the ecosystem, here we focus on how value is exchanged between different players of the ecosystem. To understand the blockchain ecosystem, let us just start with service developers. Service developers develop services and corresponding tokens, such as Bitcoin, Litecoin, and Ripple. In doing so, service developers use core blockchain technologies. Some examples of core blockchain technologies are Counterparty, Ethereum, or OpenLedger. Service developers list their tokens on exchanges, such as Coinbase and Binance. In return, exchanges facilitate the trade of tokens, thereby providing liquidity to developers. To develop their services on blockchain, service developers take the help of consultants, legal, promotional, and technological. Service developers also utilize blockchain core technologies and infrastructure service layers, such as specific databases and cryptographic algorithms. While the group of consultants, blockchain core technology developers, and infrastructure layer developers provide services and technologies to service developers, they receive accumulated user capital in return. We all know that in the realm of technology, more users leads to more uses and reputation. While developing their services, service developers also promote their projects to retail investors directly through blockchain community workshops and conferences. This promotion allows tokens or services developed by developers to be noticed by retail investors. Service developers also promote their services and tokens even after the launch to retail investors. The promotion allows retail investors to understand the services and tokens and fund them either through initial token sales or trading on exchange platforms. Service developers also try to use token ranking sites such as CoinMarketCap to promote their services or tokens to retail investors. For promoting services and tokens to retail investors, token ranking sites gather information from service developers. Token ranking sites refer retail investors to exchanges where tokens or services are listed. For generating traffic to exchanges, token ranking sites get commissions from exchanges. Token ranking sites also have click-based advertisements through which they generate revenues when retail investors click on those promotional items. Coming back to retail investors sometimes use services of digital wallet providers to carry out transactions on exchanges or on blockchains. Digital wallet providers provide easy-to-use interfaces with appropriate security to retail investors. While many digital wallet services are free and charge affiliate fees from blockchain services or services that allow fiat money, such as United States dollars, to be converted to crypto tokens. Some digital wallet service providers, especially services provided by crypto exchanges and some other examples such as BitGo, collect a commission fee from retail investors. For blockchain-based transactions, digital wallet services charge a network fee that is offered to miners. Retail investors also make use of mixers to anonymize their transactions on blockchains. Again, for providing anonymization services, mixers collect commissions from retail investors. As we have seen in the previous module, miners and mining pools validate transactions on blockchains. In order to do this, miners not only get a transaction commission from retail investors, but also receive small fixed rewards for mining from blockchain platforms, For example, on Bitcoin, the fixed reward for mining a block is 6.25 bitcoins today. Actually, the reward collected from transactions is the major component of mining revenues. In the second part of this module, we will try to understand different barriers to blockchain implementations. There are a lot of barriers to the development of blockchain-based businesses. First of all, blockchain's business applications are quite new. While Bitcoin was launched in 2009 and Ethereum in 2015, the crypto world based on blockchain technology is merely a decade old. Second, blockchain's promise of complete decentralization has met a lot of resistance from currently institutionalized, centralized models in businesses as well as in society. In this module, we will try to understand four categories of barriers: technical, business-related, behavioral, as well as legal and regulatory barriers to blockchain adoption. In terms of technical barriers, first of all, the blockchain ecosystem is quite underdeveloped. Notably, the ecosystem is secluded and is working within a bounded community rather than making alliances with the existing business community and society. Second, the blockchain has yet to see mature applications, successful poster boys such as Facebook and Amazon of the internet world. While Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Ripple in the public blockchain sphere, and Corda from R3 in private distributed ledger technology are being widely adopted, the developments are still in their early phase. Third, the number of blockchain developers that runs in thousands pales in comparison to the number of developers for platforms such as Java and traditional software development, where the numbers run in millions. Fourth, middleware that connects core technologies to high-level, easily programmable components is yet to mature in the blockchain domain. Fifth, the number of blockchain nodes have yet to reach scalability to gather critical momentum. Sixth, blockchain applications need to mile down their promise of transparency and understand that privacy of individuals and companies also matter. Definitely, private distributed ledger technologies have taken some right steps in this direction. Seventh, blockchain technology needs to work on improving security issues continuously. Regulated industries, such as banks and financial services, do not like proof-of-work mechanisms where mining pools bring centralization and can easily collaborate to reach 51% power to undermine the decentralization of blockchains. In fact, top three Bitcoin mining pools combined have already reached more than 51% mining power. Incoming quantum computers pose another threat. Such computers could easily break currently used public-private key and hashing algorithms because of the massive computational powers such systems will have. Perhaps blockchain technology needs to adopt quantum-proof cryptography. Eighth, the blockchain community needs to develop standards where different blockchain systems could communicate with each other in a more seamless fashion. Apart from the technical challenges and problems that I have highlighted, there are many business-related barriers for blockchain adoption as well. In terms of business barriers, first of all, not many companies are still convinced enough to move their operations and assets on blockchain. Second, there were many poor quality and fraudulent projects in the community. Again, this is because a lot of blockchain community members need to understand real business problems, current societal norms, and regulatory requirements to allow for the conception of better projects. Third, the adoption of blockchain technologies is still in its infancy, and not many user-friendly clients have evolved to lure new users. Fourth, Though the venture capital industry is willing to fund more blockchain products, the funding has not yet reached a critical mass. Fifth, the volatility of the cryptocurrency market is giving tokens a bad name as speculative assets. Sixth, poster boys such as Google's and Amazon's have not yet emerged. I would surmise that we have only seen Alta Vistas and Yahoo Mails of blockchain services in terms of Bitcoin, Ethereum, Ripple, DAO, and Litecoins. Seventh, with no fault of the blockchain community, the champions of blockchain technologies are fewer and far between in traditional companies. Eighth, moving to blockchain will require massive investments from companies. However, the companies have yet to accept the potential benefits of moving to blockchain system vis-a-vis their investment. Apart from technical and business barriers, there are also behavioral barriers to blockchain adoption. First of all, companies and society has yet to comprehend the potential value of blockchain applications. Second, the executives in charge of companies are unwilling to consider blockchain as a new way of doing business, at least today. Third, blockchain's promise of massive re-engineering and reorganization does not instill confidence in the minds of current business executives and society. In fact, many fraudulent cases have inflated some of the hype on blockchains. Fourth, the business best practices are slowly evolving, and most of the blockchain projects and companies are either in the experimentation phase or in the proof of concept phase. Fifth, the usability of blockchain applications needs to be improved by creating more user-friendly frontends that can run on common browsers. Though there are many such extensions available on Chrome and other browsers, the usage is yet to become widespread. Finally, in terms of legal and regulatory barriers, I would say the biggest barrier is that the legal and regulatory regimes across the world have yet to comprehend blockchain fully. Laws and regulations need to be fast enough and need to facilitate blockchain innovation. However, fraud cases in the token sale market have made regulators skeptical of blockchain. Similarly, the use of Bitcoin for buying drugs and money laundering has alerted authorities to the dark side of blockchain innovations. It may have influenced them to control rather than facilitate blockchain innovations. Furthermore, many laws and regulations were developed for non-blockchain and also I would include here non-artificial intelligence era, where machines cannot make automatic decisions. These laws need to be enhanced and reinterpreted in many regimes. In fact, a lot of research is already funded by different governments and foundations, and research is being conducted in universities to make legal and regulatory systems up to scratch. Second, financial regulators have started innovation desks, such as in Finland and Sweden, and sandbox programs, such as in the UK, to support the development of fintech and blockchain for the financial services sector. However, more such initiatives are needed from the government. Many governments in the West have also become suspicious of blockchain after China and Russia have promoted such technologies openly. Third, compliance, reporting, and taxation rules on blockchain-based businesses need to evolve. Dialogue between entrepreneurs, society, researchers, and governments would facilitate the fast and entrepreneur-friendly solutions to compliance, taxation, and reporting issues. While many non-profit organizations are working on such matters, the situation is yet to improve.